purpose that I have with my talk is precisely to defend literature as something useful nowadays. I'd like to prove how literature, and in particular Indian literature, stands as a location for cultural dialogue and global encounter, and eventually aiming for better understanding and communication among nations. I will deal with literature, presenting literature as a space for global conversation among nations, and we'll talk a little bit about the concept of cultural globalization. Secondly, we will refer a bit, we will talk a bit about the evolution of Indian writing in English, specifically the social novel. I will tell you about some Indian global writers, focusing especially on the contemporary sphere, the last generation of writers within this corpus of literature. And finally, I will focus on Aravind Adiga's works as a space precisely of confluence of the evolution of the social and the global Indian. Therefore, taking into account the context of literature, I would like to illustrate how the Indian literary text and the contemporary writers lie at the core of cultural globalization. Indian authors project their views of the contemporary world through their stories and narratives. The local, the Indian local, mixes with the global and shapes the global. And so, this makes evident that the literary text becomes a space for global, or rather global, encounter. According to Paul Hopper, in Understanding Cultural Globalization, we can distinguish three different phases in the concept of cultural globalization. The pre-modern period, which goes up to the 1500s, the modern period, which goes from the 1500s to 1945, and the last phase would be the contemporary period, covering from 1945 up to present times. This evening we are going to illustrate precisely this last phase with Indian literature in English, aiming to identify specific cultural elements which in turn and eventually will be extrapolated to a global sphere and in the end will prove a global interconnection. Before that, I want you to bear in mind the concept of imagination. Imagination gathers together symbolic and cultural elements linked to contextualize historical processes. The imagination plays then a fundamental role in the global order, since it becomes the space where social and cultural practice are organized and where negotiation between the individual and the global takes place. The Indian social novel in English shows an evolution that goes from the 1930s at the beginning of the 20th century up to the present. In the 1930s, we can talk about the founding fathers, the pioneers, you've got a name there, Gul Rakanan, Raja Rao, R.K. Narayan, those are called the pioneers of the Indian English novel. And from those times, we're going to find an influence in the contemporary present. There's been an evolution, but we're going to find a trace from the times of the founding fathers. Many Indian authors all throughout this evolution have tackled the social issue, and they have dealt with the effects of capitalism and modernization of India, especially today. Anand have been influenced by Charles Dickens, and this is going to be an interesting thing to find out. And Adiga is going to be like the confluence of these influences, right? Adiga then becomes the epitome of the global narrative, greatly influenced by Anand in this continent, who in turn has been influenced by Dickens. And so we are going to find sort of a neo-Victorian trace in both Anand, in the Indian subcontinent, and the works by Adiga. Adiga is also placed together with other writers, other 19th century writers like Edgar Allan Poe, Wilkie Collins, Le Fanu. So his narrative becomes the place where not only a global encounter takes place, but also transnational. Novels like
Kuli by Anand, like Great Expectations by Charles Dickens, Untouchable by Anand, Oliver Twist by Dickens, have a common, say, a common line. All these novels represent a society immersed in a deep, rapid socio-economic growth and transition, and the effects that this is having on individuals, emphasizing the contrast between the rich and the poor. Right? Then, as you can see, we can establish a relationship between contexts and times. We have here together 19th century England with the 1930s in India, with the 21st century in India. And this illustrates eventually the idea of the transnational. Let's concentrate now on Aravind Adiga. And there you've got a couple of his novels. He's also written Selection Day in 2016 and Between Assassinations, but we are going to concentrate basically on The White Tiger that you have there on the slide, and mention a little bit Last Man in Tower, because they have a common topic. His novels, Aravind Adiga's novels, show that India has gone global. So the image of the Indian society depicted in the novels is framed within a social structure based on money, the power of money. India is presented as a culture that has lost its identity and it is not post-colonial anymore. The White Tiger stands as an example of how the Indian novel turns into the site for the convergence of different elements of the Indian global, which depict the last phase of evolution of the concept of cultural globalization. So the universal is particularized here, and specific elements of the universal experience reflect the regional, the local distinctiveness, shaping the global. The setting that is going to become the microcosm where the plot takes place is the city, which acquires the dimension of a symbol. Other writers using the city as setting would be Amit Sanduri. This is information for you, and in case you want to have a look at them, right? He, in this novel, interrogates the modernization, the rapid modernization of the subcontinent and the complex shift that is causing on people's relations with traditions, with cultures, knowledge. Here, the city of Mumbai is represented, and the representation of Mumbai here is done through the image of the dissolute and depraved individuals who populate precisely the margins of the society. So it's the world of opium, heroin addiction that we find here, criticizing the twisted morality of this world as opposed to sort of a hypocritical attitude of middle-class Indian society. The Lola by Jhumpa Lahiri, she's an Indian-American Indian writer. And here she deals with immigration, right? How second generation immigrants are trying to find their place and get assimilated the culture of adopted America and their ancestors, Indian ancestors. And lastly, The Inheritance of Loss by Kiran Desai. This is an epic tale in which we are going to find post-colonialism and globalization related to the image of modern India, where the colonial legacy and the modernizing forces of globalization are inevitably gathered together and linked. Coming back to the symbol of the city, and this here where we are going to find this idea of the global, local identified, I want you to have a look at the quotation that you have there on the slide, referring to mega cities and around this idea of the city being a global symbol. And I read, the city, the contemporary metropolis, is for many the chosen metaphor of the modern world. In its everyday details, its mixed histories, languages, and cultures, its elaborate evidence of global tendencies and local distinctions, the figure of the city as both a real and an imaginary place apparently provides a reading map for reading, interpretation, and comprehension. Coming back to Adiga's works and The White Tiger in particular, we are going to find that the mega city that he uses as setting is New Delhi, right? So So New Delhi becomes a microcosm in which we're going to identify specific cultural elements that are local, but you will see can be identified with us as well, with the global. Overpopulation, diversity, as opposed to, you know, the most posh, so to say, parts of the city with five-star hotels, entrepreneurial buildings. Descriptions of Delhi are found all throughout The White Tiger, the novel, and you've got here one that is interesting because it appeals to the senses of the reader. We read, rush hour in Delhi, cars, scooters, motorbikes, auto rickshaws, black taxis, jostling for space on the road. The pollution is so bad that the men on the motorbikes and scooters have a handkerchief wrapped around their faces. Each time you stop at a red light, you see a row of men with black glasses and masks on their faces, as if the whole city were out on a bank heist that morning. There was a good reason for the face. They say the air is so bad in Delhi that it takes 10 years of a man's life. What Adiga aims to portray or to represent through this character is precisely the fact that there are people, there are individuals in these urban cities who try to escape from what he calls dark India, because one of the White Tiger's characteristics is precisely Adiga tries to break with this stereotypical image of India that we have and show the reality of India. He calls, or he talks about lightness and darkness in New Delhi or in India as a whole. So Balram escapes from dark India and makes his way in society, finally to become a taxi driver. He calls himself an entrepreneur, and he seems to be like the new guru. The main thing to know about Delhi is that the roads are good and the people are bad. The police are totally rotten. If they see you without a seatbelt, you'll have to bribe them 1,000 rupees. The global cultural elements appear, as I said, mixed with the local. So all these elements that can be extrapolated to the global are identified within the novel. As you can see, the contrast between the rich and the poor, multiculturalism, cosmopolitanism, the symbol of the mega city, in this particular case New Delhi, crime in the city, terrorism, lack of values, ecology, technology, all those are cultural elements that are global, but Adiga presents them through a local view. Therefore, the Indian reality presented by Adiga seems to be an image of the cultural global of our times, and contemporary Indian literature becomes then a space for a transnational dialogue that hopefully will lead to a cultural understanding of human beings in the 21st century. That's all. Thank you very much for your attention.